Guys, type 1 or 2 in the chat. Who you think is going? Type 1 for Heat and 2 for Taipei Assassins. We're gonna have Heat on offense, and they're gonna open up really quick with a nice kill to Jun. And Chi is gonna try to fight back with a few kills. He gets 3, actually. Trying to go for the ace. He's gotten 4. Can he get a 5th? He's trying to pre-fire all over the place. He actually gets an ace. Wow. I just don't even understand how TPA opening frag round on defense into warehouse gets a ace 5k. Like, what is going on here with Shi 77? You just saw his movement completely over the kid. I wasn't even prepared for that, guys. I'm strapped in, ready to go now. Let's get into this game. So now Taipei Assassins on defense lead 1-0. Really strong start by them. Just look how Shi 77 has 5-0 on that UI. That's just absolutely crazy. So yeah, we've made it to 2 minutes in the round without anyone actually dying. We are going to see 5-2 going to mid. That's going to be, I think, Gayu and Jun from Heat. It looks like there's going to be 3 players from Heat trying to go over towards 1, but there's 2 players. I think that's Crappy and Shi 77 that is sitting right on the barrels here. A nice quick exchange, but no real clear favor going in any direction except for Taipei. They've lost 4 players all of a sudden. They lost 2 players at the pipes, they lost a player at mid, and now it's all in the favor of Heat. They have 3 players up, 1 has half HP. Jay is probably the best rifle on Taipei Assassins. I'm not quite entirely sure if he's going to be able to do it. This looks really rough. He's trying to do a setup nade. He's got 4 players to kill through. He's going to do a set nade, not going to hit anyone. Lands in some nice shots onto Guile, but he's still got 3 players to go, and he won't be able to do it. So, just like that, first 2 rounds, it's all tied up 1-1 here on Hammerblow between the Taiwanese team and Korea. Gonna have to see what Korea is going to change or adapt here. If they're just gonna keep playing normally how they are going to, having players up in mid. We are gonna see Shi 77 pushing up lower, no eyes on that quite yet, but we did see Rabbit get a really nice kill to Jun. And that's just going to cause Shi 77 to back off. No reason for him to push. Roger. So now it's really in the hands of Heat here. They need to dictate some form of a pace. They need to get a pick. They need to like out rotate Taipei Assassins a little bit, cause a diversion or something. Roger. Good nades coming out, but that nade kind of failed coming out from Taipei Assassins. Doesn't really matter at this point. But now that the set nades have been thrown, we are going to see Otan pushing up on the stairs. So let's see. It's Gael still has the bomb. I think he's the designated bomb carrier, to be honest. He always has it. He's just floating in mid, sitting in the middle part of the map. Could rotate to any part of the map at any time. And I think we are going to see a commit coming up from Heat towards 1 now. They have 4 players grouping up. They only have Rapid and Crappy. Taipei Assassins only have Rapid and Crappy inside of one site. Crappy's in a pretty interesting position. It really works if you land your shots first. But yeah, it looks like Taipei Assassins is just ready to rotate in here. We are going to have to see how Shi 77 is going to lock this down in the little hallway here. Coming to the spawn, Clan Heat is going to smoke it. And here comes the push. Crappy will get taken down immediately. Clan Heat just gets 3 kills just like that. Taipei Assassins does get 2 of their own, but is that going to be enough to retake the site? It is a 2-on-3. AST gets a nice kill on 2. I think that was Shi 77. So yeah, it's all into Eltan, the scope for Taipei Assassins. He needs to clutch a 1v3 in 20 seconds right now. And he is not going to be able to do it. Guile is going to take him out. Alright, so that's going to be the second round, I believe, going to Detonator. Not Detonator, Heat, I should say. Yeah, it's currently 2-1 for Heat. Heat is on offense, so they need to win a couple more rounds here to get past that defensive-sided favor. But all of a sudden, AGP is just shooting through the box, and it's just this crazy pre-fire. I took down Eltan. I don't know if that was a call or what was going on there. Anyways, Jay is sitting on the site trying to defend it. He gets 1 kill. It was a really nice kill, but he can't follow up with that kill onto Guile. Guile is going to have the bomb. I think he is going to plant. Yeah, especially with that kill from AGP going onto Jay. Without Archie, that was on GT77. Alright, so there's four players up for a heat. They have all the angles covered. It's pretty much up to Crappy now in a 1v4. Yeah, he's not gonna be able to do it. Gonna be taken out immediately. And all of a sudden, yeah, they do have some pretty awesome headset stream, and they have really awesome mouse pads. Like, everything they have is sponsored by their team. So it is gonna be 3-1 now for the offensive team. Clan Heat just slightly pulling away here. Let's see if they can keep it up. But Taipei Assassins, they are trying to be not really aggressive. They're just, I don't know what Taipei Assassins are trying to do right now. They were trying to push that hole there, but G77 died due to Jhun just, paying attention, basically. Hammerblow does get played on ESL, by the way. Not sure where that's coming from, Blood Artist. Basically, Clan Heat, they got an opening frag. They're just setting up. They've acquired map control. They have the dominance around it, and now they're just setting up for some set nades, and then I feel they're going to push into one. Once again, they have Crappy and Rapid to deal with, some of the lesser rifles, I would say, on Taffy Assassin. But let's see if they can prove me wrong here with this push that is going to go into one. Oh, look at that. Jay pushes out a warehouse, gets a nice frag over at two. Is probably going to tell his team that, hey, there's no one else over here. Get ready for that push. Oh, just like that, we have AGP and AST taking out the players that are trying to defend that one side. It's only going to be up to Rapid now. Actually, it's going to be up to two players on Taipei Assassins. Sorry about that. It's going to be up to Jay and Rapid. They are going to push in from the same door, spawn door. We're going to come into the site, not getting any kills. Actually, Jay does get a kill, but Rapid is just going to get swarmed from the remaining players. And, yeah, Heat is just showing absolute control in this map. Like, they're 4-1 right now. They've won more than enough rounds for offense to carry it over to the defensive side. I'm really concerned for how Taipei Assassin's going to play offense now with such a huge round deficit. At most, Taipei Assassin's could get two rounds here, but they just lost Jay, one of their star players, and not sure how it's gonna work out. She is trying to be aggressive, trying to work something, trying to be creative. He does get one kill, but Taipei Assassins, they lose four players just like that in a span of 12 seconds. It looks very bleak. But L10 is never going to give up. He's in 1v4, he's gotten one kill. Can he follow it up? Can he get this shot through the smoke? That would be huge for him. Turn into a 1v2, but he's not quite able to. Too many smokes, too many grenades, not enough time. Bomb actually hasn't gone down yet. A little bit of a flub, giving Elton a bit more opportunity than he should have. He's going to get flashed immediately. He's going to try to push up, be aggressive, going to one at the AST. Mike is spotted by number three from the back. He's just going to get shot from all angles, going to get pinched. And alright, that's going to be 5-1 to Heat, the Korean team that was on offense. Pretty surprising to see that result, but it's not really surprising when you think that Heat is the better team. They are the number one favorite team. Anyways, Taipei Assassins, they're going to be on offense. Let's see if their aggression can shine through here. Break through that defensive hole that we've seen from Heat. Heat is not Asterisk. I think they actually beat Asterisk to get here, or Asterisk disbanded and it wasn't quite the same team. So yeah, Heat is definitely regarded as the number one team currently within all the regions. They are the most favored team to win this event behind AHQ. Or ahead of AHQ, I should say. Alright, so we have a huge push in here from Taipei Assassins going to Warehouse. They drop Jhun pretty easily, but can they get through AGP? AGP only gets one before he falls. And now AST up on the two site with that scope. Is it going to be able to close it out for his team? And just like that, is it going to be a 3v3? Where is Taipei Assassins going to try to go? They have the bomb on Rapid. It looks like he's going to try to go to double doors, but they also have Elton over at the one site trying to either be a lurking role as a scope. Not quite sure how that's going to work out, especially if number five tries to rotate. Only time will tell how this round will pan out. Number five is going to fight up with Octane. That's going to be Elton getting the pick on to Otan there. Excellent job. Opening up a little bit of room here. It's going to be a 2v3. Going to have to see how AST tries to defend his spawn. Misses the shot. Knows there's a player behind him, tries to kill him, can't get the pistol shots, try to pull out the rifle, the scope again, but it's not gonna work out. And now Gael, who was playing side of the one side, is going to push out, going to get that kill onto L10, takes out the scope. That's a really big kill considering Rapid has 1 HP and Jay has around 80. But he can't quick get through the wall. That is Jay. Jay is a really formidable player there. And Taipei Assassin is going to win their second round, are going to try to bring it back, are just going to lay down and take it. I'm not sure if Asterix disbanded or if they just didn't compete or if they did compete. I really didn't watch the qualifiers for it. All I know is Heat came first. Alright, so TPA is pushing towards this bridge, but Heat is actually pushing themselves towards the bridge. They lose two players. Taipei Assassins only loses one. Not sure I agree with that trade. That defense should never be down a player, especially two players, except for that too. Who is that? That's AGP is sitting right outside of this hole. She could run right straight into him if he's not careful. He's probably aware of it though, as Asian teams do like to push here, but wasn't quite prepared for that. No crosshair placement, just kind of walking back and forth. AGP, easy kill. He's now 9-3 for his team. If anyone is winning this for his team who's 5-2, it is definitely AGP. Let's see if he can continue this on throughout the round. He's trying to push up through hole. He's on the trails of Crappy and Jay. Doesn't quite see them. He doesn't actually backtrack into spawn, so good move by him. He's going to slowly walk into warehouse. Meanwhile, what's going to happen over here with Jay? I mean, Gaigul is going to be able... Oh, okay, AGP is on the trail. He gets the first kill and gets the second, going to close the round out. That's going to be 6-2 now for Heat. One round away from winning the first map in this semi-final series. Just excellent play coming up from Heat. It's clear, concise, coordinated. Yeah, they've lost two rounds, but you know, whatever. Kind Heat, John is going to be pushing with his Desmodus to hole. Going to run into probably Shi here. It takes down Shi pretty easily. Going to drop down to hole. Going to go down lower. No, he's going to back off. Not going to push his advantage. Smart play from him. Especially since the carry of Clan Heat, AGP, has actually fallen pretty early. He's 11-4 for his team right now. Not having him to work his magic in the next 2 minutes of the round is pretty devastating. So we're going to have to see how Heat is able to carry this round without their main carry. AST is still 6-2 though, and John does have 7 kills. John now has 8 kills. Can he find an 8th? No, he cannot. He will fall in the warehouse, but he does call it out for his team where Taipei is actually going. We actually do see Elton is just lurking over at 1 as usual. He never plays with his team. He's always lurking. He actually does manage to get a kill. That's really bad for Heat. They shouldn't have let that happen, but they do punish it. Good job to Heat for that follow-up. We are going to see ourselves in a 2-on-2 situation yet again. Lots on the line here for Taipei Assassins. If they're unable to do this, they lose a huge, huge advantage. Basically by losing your first map. I'm pretty sure the Glock Neon is actually allowed in ESL, or at least it will be. Oh no, the Glock Neon has an extra bullet, that's why it's not allowed. Alright, so AST and OTAN trying to just, you know, find something. TPA is going to push in. Jay actually finds L10 there. I don't quite know what L10 was looking at. Oh, I think that was Gaigul. Never mind. I'm sorry. Charge set. And just like that, Taipei win their third round. Yeah, ESL just tries to adhere to the majority. So what is most fair and not pay to win, because our version isn't quite like other games where guns are cheaper or whatever. Anyways, it is currently 6-3 for Heat. They are on defense, they have the advantage, and look at OTAN here getting the first frag. He's just spraying through the flash. He could only get one kill. Heat has lost two players now. It's gonna be really hard to get back this one site. Especially with LTAN, who is lurking around at mid, gonna slowly creep up onto AST if he's not careful. AC is actually aware that potentially a player could be coming from behind, but doesn't matter, L10 is prepared for it. And now it's only going to be two players against the four of Taipei Assassins on this retake. John just runs straight in, gets the kills. All of a sudden, it's a 2-on-2. Now it's a 1-on-2 here. John with the scope misses the pre-fire scope onto. Actually, Taipei Assassin seems to be bringing it back. They were down 4 rounds to Clan Heat, and now they are only down 2. If they can continue this trend, it could be a 6-6 here, but I mean, Heat just has to capitalize on one mistake from Taipei Assassins, and it will be all over for this map for TPA. Alright, so TPA, they're pretty much spread out. They have 2 in hole, they have 1 lurking at the warehouse, they have 1 on the bridge, and then Crappy's just kind of floating around in spawn, not really contributing much. But it's still pretty early in the round, only 30 seconds have passed thus far. And let's see what Heat is trying to do. Heat has a standard 2-player setup inside of 1, and they have 2 players in warehouse, and then they just have AST, their primary scope, sitting in their spawn. Not quite. It's really tough to call if TPA is actually going to commit to this warehouse. They are setting up for it. But again, they're going to run into John and AGP, the players that have the most amount of kills on Heat. This could be a terrible decision to make, running into the best players of the other team, the players that are performing the best right now. And alright, AGP spots them, gets the call out, and all of a sudden John just comes flying down. Eagle gets a 2 crazy kill into Crappy, and I don't even know what John was doing there. Just, I hope you guys saw that on the video, that he just came flying down and just got 2 kills. AGP did get dropped, but now there's only 3 players from Taipei that can potentially make this out. Alright, so let's hop onto Rapid, I guess. See what they can do. They're sitting over here at 1. They're trying to get a pick or something on the rotation back into the site, but yeah, AST is just going to demolish anyone who tries to go up that hallway. And now just 2 players remain for Taipei Assassins. 2 remaining hopes, Jay and Rapid, are going to peek it, but look at Gaiul just playing up on that box. Oh, but look at that excellent pre-fire from Rapid. Good, smart play from him, but it's not having fun being in Taiwan. And alright, here we are loading to the second map. It is Heat's map to win here for the series point. And John has a shotgun and just takes out Jay. I don't even know what to say about that. Clan Heat, Otan gets a nice opening frag as well. She-77 is very low HP for Taipei Assassins, and he just got demolished. What is up with this shotgun? Do not tell me this is a legitimate strategy. Please tell me Heat is just toying with their prey. Yeah, Emotion 666, I don't think this tournament's a joke, I think it's pretty serious, but I think Heat is realizing how much stronger than Taipei Assassins they actually are, just because of how badly they beat them on Hammer Blow. And, you know, it seems to be working. Like, the Blue Skull does, like, one-shot kill from pretty far away if you can headshot them. You know, all it would take is one headshot for Jun to die as well, so it's an equal trade when there's AK-12s on the other side as well. I think it would be fun to see these guns used in like a competitive environment and our region blood artist, but I don't think a lot of people would like to play against a Blue Skull every tournament. I think that would take away from some of their enjoyment, as has been the case, as they've stated. Okay, so AST is just lining up frags here, getting the kills onto Jun and. Sorry, getting kills onto She-77 and Rapid. Alright, Crappy does get a frag. It's going to be a 1v2 here for Gaiu. Gaiu, of course, being on Clan Heat. Will he be able to do this and take his team to a second round victory? Yeah, Gaiu isn't gonna have a chance, gonna get destroyed immediately. I'd like to see a 5v5 demolition cup with everyone using a trench gun. I think that'd be great. Anyways, we're gonna be seeing TPA pushing really hard in here into the one double doors area. She77, of course, gets his opening frag and crappy right through the wall. Gets another one. Just these wall bangs are just absolutely crazy coming up from the Asian teams. They're always wall banging through smoke, through walls, through anything. But yeah, crappy is gonna back off out of there. Alright, so Clan Heat is down two players. That's pretty rough for defense on airplane, but it's still manageable if the players on each site. Like if OTN can somehow get one or two frags here, as it does look like Type B Assassins is aiming towards that one. There are gonna be some set smokes and nades coming out. OTN is gonna get flashed, he's gonna hide in the corner, but that death mode from Shi is just too quick. And Rapid is gonna take out the rotate attempt from Clan Heat here. Ace trying to long range pistol there, but it's not gonna work out. Alright, so Type B Assassins has taken a one round lead now. It's going to be towards. Actually, it's actually Crappy. That's Crappy and Elton that are really doing a lot of work for Type B right now. See if they can continue that on. They're, of course, on the offensive side. She is going to push into the site. He's going to kind of get fooled around a little bit. Actually, Clan Heat is actually trying to fight back a little bit, but there's like slight glimmer of hope kind of just disappeared there. And it's right back now as it's a 3v3. Bomb is going to be planted on two site. It's a pretty strong looking hold here from Taipei. We do see Gagool coming from behind. He is making a lot of noise. Elten should turn around. Oh, but he misses the shot just ever so slightly. Gagool does get the kill. And now Rapid and the rest of Taipei are just trapped on site. They will get taken out. And now he just needs to really just defuse the bomb.
Charge defused. Operation.
Yeah, a lot of pressure here on Type B Assassins not to get eliminated. They don't want to come. They don't want to tie for third and fourth. They want to come first. Alright, so AST is in a pretty good spot to get a few kills here. They do let Ski77 through to the window, which I think is a major mistake. They should definitely be able to prevent that from happening. And Type B Assassins does actually take out Crappy. We are going to see AST. He's getting flashed. Not really able to impact or halt this push. He's alone on the site. He's fighting close range, getting two kills as well. On the site now, we do see Rapid playing in the window and L10 playing at the double doors. This is gonna be really hard for just Clan Heat to actually win this. That Nay needs to kill someone. Two players left, 15 seconds left in the round. Gaiul, look at that, Gaiul getting both of the kills. AST getting a 3k, Gagool getting a 2k, they are going to be able to defuse the bomb. And that's something we weren't seeing from Andromeda when Andromeda was playing against, when they were playing against Heat on this map. They didn't have people going through that tunnel, they didn't have someone flanking from behind ready to go into that tunnel. And they just kind of looked, you know, like pigeons waiting on, like, a wire waiting to get electrocuted or something for that bomb. But, good job from Clan Heat showing us how it's done, giving us a nice tutorial video for 2015. AST slightly missing the shot through the smoke. We notice a lot of Asian scopes are able to shoot through the smoke and land the shots, actually. Something we don't see a lot from the European or North American teams. And this is going to be the last round for the half, so pretty much this game will get turned on its head in the next half, as it is Airplane. And shout out to XMobileX and XReiku for following the channel. You guys are great. I think we're actually at 2,500 followers now, so congratulations to all the viewers and all the spectators. Thanks for all the hard work of following the channel. Anyways, back to Taipei Assassins. Let's see what they're going to try to do. They like to favor that one site a little bit. But we're going to have to see exactly what they're going to be able to do. 1, 3, and 4, that's going to be Crappy, Jay, and Rabbit are looking towards a 2-push. That's going to be all of the Riflemen, and we're just going to have She-77. He's probably either going to go from mid or something. But we do see L10 as a scope. He's pushing up to Blue Room underneath it, actually. Crappy's going to run into Guile. Guile here, oh my gosh, Crappy just pre-fire pushes into it with a player coming from behind him. No one really dies yet. Guile is going to get the upper hand, does take down Jay, but just like that, Crappy's ready to go in right again, but Jund is prepared for such crazy strategies. We also see AGPP coming in massively for the team, and just a really good team effort there from Clan Heat, winning that first half 4-2, and now we are going to see the side switch. Clan Heat is going to be on offense. We'll give away 2 giveaway codes after this map for hitting 2,500 followers. I don't have any more actually to give away. I need to get restocked. Shout out to the GMs there to restock me for the remaining few matches that we have. So we see Taipei Assassin. They actually set 2 players up here in this room. Is that going to work out? Oh my gosh. What just happened there? That was She-77 getting a 3k onto all the important players of Heat. And Heat is down to 1 player. It's going to be AST. He's in a 1v3. He gets the first kill. Can he find the second kill for his team? Misses it slightly. Both players are sitting in Blue Room. This could be a potential clutch for AST. It's going to be rough for him. He's got a minute 40 to work with. I don't know if Taipei Assassin is actually going to peek him, but I believe AST is probably going to try to go towards spawn. And just like this, he hears them drop, misses the shot. They actually don't know that he slipped by. He misses a shot again, and that's going to be the death of him. You can't miss 5-6 shots like that. Yeah, Raven, I did say 3 giveaways, and I will give 3 giveaways away as soon as I do get codes. But I will give away 2 giveaways after this map to make up for it, as that's all I have left to give for you guys. Alright, so Taipei Assassin is at that 3-round mark, and he's at 4. Neither team has lost a player quite yet, but we do see Taipei Assassin's defense is getting a little bit weaker. Look at this HP, all of a sudden it's just vanishing for Taipei. I don't know if they have enough HP to actually properly defend against a full-on push from 2 AK-12s and a Death Modus, as well as an AK-47 Lion. AST hunting for this pick onto L10, but he's not finding it. AST just not hitting any of his shots. Hope you guys can be quick to get that code in the chat. Good luck. Make sure you're logged in when you redeem it. Alright, so AST finally lands a shot into L10. That's going to open up the 2 site massively. There's only 1 player in there. I think that is Rapid that's sitting over there. And just like that, Clan Heat win the offensive round. It is now going to be 5-3 for Heat. Two more rounds and Heat will be playing in the grand finals tomorrow. And Taipei Assassins will be tied for 3rd and 4th and they'll be out of the tournament. Alright, it's all up to L10 here to defend this bombsite. Oh, he doesn't get the shot onto Jun, I believe, who's pushing into that window. He also misses the shot onto AGP, who also pushed into there as well. Who was that that just got that kill? That was Jay getting a nice kill onto Gayu. Gayu was trying to push into that, all of a sudden I forget what this room is called. Alright, so AST is still in the prowl. He is scoping in with his FRF2 legend. OTAN trying to throw a nade. Actually hits the ceiling. Oh, he gets one tapped by Crappy. When I look at Taipei Assassins here, I don't see any player actually doing amazingly. They're all pretty close in kills except for Jay, who's kind of underperforming right now. I think if he was playing to how he's playing against everyone, every other team he's played against, they'd probably have already won this game. So maybe a little bit of a letdown from Jay, but the rest of the team is trying to keep them in the game. Clan Heat have lost two players though. They've actually now lost three players, and this is looking dire for them in this round. Well, they have one player up in a 1v4. Yeah. Alright, so we're gonna have to see how Taiwan is gonna be able to do this. They have three rounds to get while Clan Heat has two. Press 1 if you think Taipei Assassin is gonna bring it back. Press 2 if you think it's gonna be Heat. And that's gonna be AGP getting a nice opening frag onto Xi77. Xi77, one of the most impact players of this entire map so far from Taipei Assassins. That's definitely a crucial kill that they needed to get. Alright, so Jay, with that UAV through the smoke, isn't actually going to see anyone going to back off, as we do see Heat trying to rotate over towards one, I believe. I don't think Heat has actually tried to go to one yet. Or at least if they have, they've only had one player going there and they've been shut down. See a lot of twos. I think Heat is the big time favorite here, guys. Alright, so Jay is sitting in that blue room. I think he's actually gonna go aggro and try to get a peek. This could set him in a really bad position. He actually gets a few nice shots at the Jhon, but now he's 1 HP himself. He's very low, and look at that, Jhon just runs through the smoke and gets the kill. We are gonna see L10 getting a nice kill to AGP. AST died from crappy.
Charge set.
All tied up to a 3-on-3. Definite HP advantage going to Taipei. Their retake could be pretty easy, pretty smooth sailing if they can get the positioning just right. And look at this, 1 and 4 just both together, and they just go into blue room together. All three of them actually. And look at this, it's all up to Guile in a 1v2. He gets one kill, but doesn't actually quite get it. So just like that, guys, it's all tied up 5-5. It went from a 4-2 all the way to 5-5. Taipei Assassins are definitely bringing it back. I don't know, Heat is kind of letting their 2-0, like easy street kind of out of their hands. But maybe we'll see Heat try to perform a little bit better here on offense. Of course, Airplane is considered defensive sided, at least until you get into a site. Alright, so a lot of setups from nades, a lot of pre-fires, but yet no one has actually died. It's only Crappy who's actually taking a little bit of damage along with Jhon. Alright, so Heat has actually been able to get into this window, and where the heck is that Xi playing up on the box there? Actually, that's a really cool place to be playing. And Xi is now very low HP. He's gonna be taken out. Jhon going absolutely massive, potentially winning this round for his team. Just opening up the site so easily. Is he actually trying to shoot his teammate a little bit of miscommunication there. That jump scope was pretty scary to me. But smokes are going to be going out. Bomb has yet to actually make it into the site. Jay is actually trying to be proactive here, pushing into the site, going to be taken down. Now it's up to Rapid and L10 to get the two players out of window and double doors, as well as the player that is remaining on the bomb site. This is going to be really rough for Rapid and L10. This is one of the hardest sites to try and take back. And just like that, it's going to be Heat winning that round. It's now going to be 6-5. They are one round away from knocking out Taipei Assassins. TPA, they need to search deep and just win the next two rounds if they're really in it for the long haul here. Alright, so Heat stacking up over at the double doors. What are they going to be able to do? Actually, I think they're just waiting around, waiting to see what's going to happen. And interesting to note, I think Taipei Assassins has Xi77 playing up at mid. That's actually something we haven't seen any team play so far on Airplane. First ones to do it. They also have Crappy playing over on the 2 side, and they have Jay over floating at the mid. But here is a potential 2 push coming out. Alright, so Rapid L10 are going to have to defend this. Jay is very low HP now. Nade's coming out from Jhon. TPA is getting pushed out of position a little bit, but the push actually doesn't come out from Heat. so TPA is going to be able to slide right back into their proper angles. And now it looks like Heat is a little stuck. I don't know quite what they're trying to look for. AST isn't actually actively looking for a pick. So puzzle me confused here on what Heat is doing. Now they're going to throw some nades. They are going to get Rapid backed off a little bit. I think that was their opening, but Rapid potentially going huge here. Gets one kill. He's looking for more. He's in a really good position here. Turns to his left, gets the second kill into AGP. Can he find the third? No, he cannot. But Heat have taken it to a 2-on-2. John is going to try to plant that bomb, I imagine. So bomb is now down, but look at this. She77 is actually in the window waiting for someone to come and kill him. But there's a player coming up from behind him and he's not aware of it. OTAN. OTAN backs off just in the nick of time and he takes down She77. And that's going to be Heat winning it. 2-0 now to Heat. Heat knocking out TPA from the semifinal.